Let us first consider what is the definition of a child. According to CRC, children are defined as those who are below the age of 18 years. What is childhood? It is recognized in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights as a period entitled to special care and assistance. In response to the growing concern in most countries of Europe and North America for the protection of children following the First World War, the newly formed League of Nations established a Committee on Child Welfare in 1919. The private agencies also felt the need to provide broad social standards for the protection of children. Of particular importance was Save the Children International Union. Inspired largely by the work of Egalitarian Jeb, who had founded Save the Children in response to her own experience with child victims of war. Now, what did Save the Children International Union do? In 1923, it adopted as its charter a 5-point declaration which described the basic condition of society and it should meet in order to provide adequate protection and care for its children. The next year, the Union persuaded the League of Nations to adopt the same declaration. In 1924, League of Nations adopted the Declaration of the Rights of the Child, which came to be known as the Declaration of Geneva, recognizing that mankind owes to the child the best that it has to give. The simple principles of the declaration establish the basis of child rights in terms of both protection of the weak and vulnerable and promotion of the child's development. The declaration also made it clear that the care and protection of children was no longer the exclusive responsibility of either the family or the community or even the individual country. The whole world as a whole had a legitimate interest in the welfare of the children. Declaration of Geneva had the following points. The first being, children must be given the means needed for its normal development, both materially and spiritually. The second, hungry children should be fed, sick child should be helped, erring child should be reclaimed, and the orphan and the homeless child should be sheltered. Child must first to receive relief in times of distress. Repeat. Child must be the first to receive relief in times of distress. Declaration of Geneva, if we continue, also states that children must be in a position to earn a livelihood and must be protected against every form of exploitation. Child must be brought up in the consciousness and its best qualities are to be used in the service of its fellow men. So, child rights and how it has been taken up by the world community as a whole. In 1945, the United Nations Organization, that was earlier the League of Nations, became United Nations Organization in 1945. In 1946, the Economic and Social Council of the United Nations recommended that the Geneva Declaration be reaffirmed as a sign of commitment to the cause of children. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights was adopted by the United Nations General Assembly in 1948. The United Nations General Assembly adopted Declaration of Rights of the Child in 20th November 1959, which was expansion of Geneva Declaration from 5 principles to 10 basic principles. The International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights was adopted by the General Assembly in 1966. It also upholds the rights of the child. In 1989, world leaders decided that children needed a special convention just for them because people under 18 years old often needed special care and protection that adults do not. The leaders also wanted to make sure that the world recognized that children have human rights too. The Convention on the Rights of the Child, CRC, you must remember we have defined child by the definition of CRC at the beginning of the slide, is the first legally binding international instrument to incorporate the full range of human rights, civil, cultural, economic, political, and social rights together. The convention sets out these rights in 54 articles. It spells out the basic human rights that children everywhere have. The right to survival, to develop to the fullest, to protection from harmful influences, abuse and exploitation, and to participate fully in family, cultural and social life. The four core principles of the convention are, the first being non-discrimination, second, devotion to the best interest of the child, the right to life, survival and development, respect for the views of the child. The convention also protects children's rights by setting standards in healthcare, education, legal, civil and social services. Three UN international instruments in the child justice fields are, the first, the UN Standard Minimum Rules 1985, also known as the Beijing Rule. The second, the UN Guidelines for the Protection of Juvenile Delinquency, the Riyadh Guidelines adopted in 1990. The third, UN Standard for Protection of Juveniles Deprived of Their Liberty, the JDL or Havana Rules adopted in 1990. Now we shall talk about RTE. RTE, as you know, is Right to Education. A significant effort in this direction is the provision for children to free and compulsory education. This came into force from 1st April 2010. From that day, elementary education became a fundamental right. If we talk of the background for RTE, it is Article 21A. Which inserted in fundamental rights as per 86th constitutional amendment. The state shall provide free and compulsory education to all children of the age of 6 to 14 years in such manner as the state may by law determine was stated. The Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009 came through this. The RTE Act requires the state to provide free and compulsory education to all children in the age group of 6 to 14 years and to prepare curriculum inconsistent with constitutional values. It aims at quality education by setting norms to schools and providing quality teachers. The Act attempts at social reformation and protection of the child. It also removes the operation of examination and provides statutory role for the civil society. The Act has clearly stated the responsibility of governments, local bodies, schools, teachers, parents, and the community as a whole. Now, other points that we would like to characterize right to education as, the right of children we must discuss under this. To free and compulsory admission, attendance and completion of elementary education. Free, no child liable to pay any fee or expense preventing her from pursuing and completing elementary education. Compulsion, on the state parental duty to send the children to school. Non-enrolled oblique dropout children be admitted to age appropriate class. No child shall be failed or expelled up to class 8. Bars corporal punishment and any kind of mental harassment. What does RTE speak of the teachers? RTE says that qualification for appointment of teachers to be laid down by academic authority authorized by the central government. Academic responsibilities of teachers should be laid down, prohibits deployment of teachers for non-education purpose except for decennial census, disaster relief, elections to parliament, state legislatures and local bodies. Thus you see that it is only in these three acts that the teachers can be used out of school. The rest of the time the teacher must devote himself to the school, himself or herself to the school and to quality education. Now what should be the standard of the schools? The first we must talk about is norms and standards specified for all schools. Infrastructure and related facilities. That the school should provide ample infrastructure to the student so that he or she may be able to pursue their education. There should be an appropriate pupil-teacher ratio in each of the school. The number of school days and working hours for the teacher should be specifically mentioned. Community participation in schools ensured through SMC, comprising elected representative teachers and parents. All aided schools to provide free education to at least 25% of the children. Special category of schools and unaided schools to admit in class 1 at least 25% of the children belonging to weaker section and disadvantaged group from the neighborhood of the school, and provide free and compulsory elementary education to these children. There should be no capitation fees, no screening for admission, and no school without recognition. Now, what should the curriculum be like? The curriculum must conform to constitutional values. That is, a curriculum should be value oriented. It should make the child free from fear, trauma, and anxiety. Be child-centered, child-friendly, provide for children through activities. That is, the way of instruction should be learner-centered, and the strategies for instruction should be child-friendly. Medium of instruction. It is the right of every child to get their first education in their mother tongue. So, the child's mother tongue is to be the medium of instruction as far as possible. Provide for comprehensive and continuous evaluation, and there should be no board examination till completion of elementary education. Now, how does this lead to the protection of the rights of the children? There is decentralized grievance redressal mechanism. There is NCPCR and SCPCR assigned additional functions to, first, examine and review safeguards for rights under this act and recommend measures for effective implementation. Inquire into complaints relating to child's right to free and compulsory education. Powers are assigned under section 14 and 24 of the Commission for Protecting of Child Rights Act. When State Council for Protection of Child Rights was not constituted, appropriate government may constitute an authority. In overview, we may say a detailed study of the provisions of the Act makes one understand that there is a very close relationship between RTE Act and the rights of the child. The RTE Act provides for equity, special training for the needy, a learner-centered approach to education, individualized education plan, and abolition of any kind of corporal punishment or any mental harassment to the children. All these are linked to the right of education of the child. It is the responsibility of all Indians to see that the children of school-going age are in the school, get quality education without physical punishment or mental harassment, and complete elementary education, which is free and compulsory. At the end of this session, we may say that the right to education and the UN initiatives are very closely related, because right to education is a fundamental right that has been bestowed to all children all over the world. Thus, Right to Education as an Act of 2009 that started in 2010 broadens and strengthens the UN initiative for the rights of the children. Thank you.